Welcome back, everyone. It is Amelia. I hope you are fine. Here is everything you need to know before watching The Acolyte on Disney Plus. Excitement is building for The Acolyte, the upcoming Star Wars TV show set a century before the events of the Skywalker saga. Teasers are doing a good job of establishing the context that this is before the Empire and before the manners, but viewers can be forgiven for wanting a little more detail. The Acolyte is set at the tail end of the High Republic era, a period that's been explored before in Star Wars TV shows, novels, and comics. This means a lot of lore has been established already. Although The Acolyte is sure to explain everything, this context means viewers will benefit from some background knowledge. Here are all the most important takeaways. The High Republic era was a time of peace, with the Republic flourishing, and the Jedi as well. There were 10,000 Jedi at the time of The Acolyte, scattered across the galaxy, trained at outposts from the galactic core to the Outer Rim. The Jedi lived among the people, interacting with civilians, involved in everyday life, and battling against crime and injustice. The Jedi Order was more accepting at this time as well, allowing older recruits in some circumstances and not outright forbidding attachments. This likely helped lead to greater numbers, as a higher age bracket means more recruits. Even if they were not accepted into the main branch of the Jedi Order, it was likely that other sects of Force worship, like the Convocation of the Force on Jedha, would take them. The High Republic era lasted from 500 BBY to roughly 100 BBY, meaning the Acolyte is close to the end of this part of the Star Wars timeline. Exactly what ended this golden age of Jedi advancement is uncertain at this time, as it has not yet been covered in any of the content pertaining to the High Republic as of yet. However, it is possible that the Acolyte could depict this fall, showing what exactly led to the era of the prequel trilogy and the Jedi Order changing. Not only would this help to highlight the differences between the two versions of the Jedi Order, but it would also more directly point out the flaws in the Jedi Order that raised Anakin Skywalker. It was not a perfect place, with some parts of it directly contributing to the eventual rise of the Emperor and Darth Vader. It will be interesting to see that chain of events going forward, starting with the Acolyte and ending with Star Wars Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. The Jedi are of the High Republic era were much more willing to experiment with the Force, developing more unconventional Force powers. Jedi Master Aval Chris, for example, experienced the Force as music and possessed the ability to meld the power of all other Jedi, as a conductor would lead an orchestra. With Aval's ability, the Jedi were able to accomplish far more together than they could apart. The Acolyte will feature Rebecca Henderson as the live-action Vernestra Roach, a Maryland Jedi who will be over a century old at the time of the Disney Plus TV show. She possesses unusual Force powers based around the navigation of hyperspace and is able to experience visions of other places when she travels through hyperspace. It's unknown whether these Force powers give me some ideas related to my video in comments on below. If you like this video and subs for more upcoming videos.